On reaching Ayodhya, Lord Ramachandra heard that in the absence his brother Bharata was eating barley cooked in the urine of a cow, covering his body with the bark of trees and wearing matted locks of hair, and lying on the mattress of Kusha. The most merciful Lord very much lamented. Bharata was very sad, Bharat Maharaj was very sad, that because of him all this has happened, so much hostility is there. And therefore what he did, he personally, and you know, because of him, there was so much pain caused to Lord Ramachandra. So what he did, because of this, he personally took a lot of austerities and penances. When Lord Bharata understood that Lord Ramachandra was returning, he went to receive him. And after offering the wooden shoes before Lord Ramachandra, Lord Bharata stood with folded hand, with eyes full of tears. And Lord Ramachandra bade Bharat with tears while embracing him with both arms for a long time. Accompanied by Mother Sita and Lakshmana, Lord Ramachandra offered his respectful obeisances unto the learned Narayana, an elderly person of the family. And all the citizens of Ayodhya offered their respectful obeisances unto the Lord. Citizens of Ayodhya, upon seeing their king return after a long absence, offered him flower garlands, waved their upper cross, and danced in great jubilation. People already attached to him. They waited for 14 years to see kings for like that, not like today. O king, Lord Bharata carried Lord Ramachandra in wooden shoes. Sugriva and Vibhishna carried a disc, an excellent fan. Hanuman carried a white umbrella. And Shatrughna carried a bow and two quivers. And Sita Devi carried a water pot filled with the water from the boiling place. Angada carried a sword, but Jamavan, the king of Riksha, carried a golden sheep. O King Parikshana, the Lord sat on aeroplane of flowers with women offering him prayers and recitals chanting about his characteristics. He appeared like a moon with the stars and planets. So finally he reached his place. Thereafter, having been welcomed by his brother Bharata, Lord Ramachandra entered the city of Ayodhya in the midst of the festival. When he entered the palace, he offered obeisances to all the mothers, including Kekeyi and other wives of Maharaj Dasharatha, especially his own mother, Kaushalya. He also offered obeisances to the spiritual preceptors such as Vasishtha and friends of his own age and younger friend Vasishtha. And he returned their respectful obeisances as with Lakshmana and Mother Sita. In this way, they entered the palace. So the mothers received their children, they were very happy. Upon seeing the son, the mothers of Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata, Shatrughna immediately arose, like unconscious body returning to consciousness. The mothers placed their sons on their laps and bathed them with tears, thus relieving themselves of a grief of a long separation. The family priest of the spiritual master Vasishtha and Lord Ramachandra keenly shaved their matted locks of hair, and then they did Abhisheka for it. And Lord Ramachandra fully bathed his head, clean shaven, dressed himself very nicely, and decorated with a garland and ornament, very shone brightly, surrounded by his brothers and wives, for similarly dressed and ornamented. And finally, Tretayam, Vardhamanayam, Kalam, Krito, Samo, Abhavat, Rame, राजनी धर्मग्ने सर्वभूता सुखावये. Lord Ramachandra became the king during Tretayuga, but because of his good government, the age was like Satyuga. Everyone was religious and completely happy. When Lord Ramachandra, the supreme personality, God of the king of the world, all bodily and mental suffering, disease, old age, bereavement, lamentation, distress, fear and fatigue were completely absent. There was even no death for those who did not want it. So basically, Lord Ramachandra converted this world to Vaikuntha, as, or we can say, as in the Satyuga. Now, after this revising the pastime, and most of you knew the pastime, but Ramakatha on the day of Ramnavami is Ramnavami in the meaning. Let us meditate on different lessons from this time. The first lesson that we can know is that the Lord's potencies are inconceivable. You know, sometimes we see many people today declare, I am God. Quite common. I am God. Many gods are there. Some people may get angry, but one God recently had a heart attack. He was in great crisis. Doctors had to save his life. He ran to doctors. Doctors, please save my life. And now doctors have detected jaundice and they are still in critical condition. God is not like that. Not like this, there are not one, many gods today. People don't even know what is the definition of God. It is rather, please don't take it, insult to God to make ordinary people God like us. Some people even say Hanuman is God. He feels hurt if he speaks such statements. He is the servant of the Supreme God. Prabhupada used to say, whole world is mad because they say there is no God. But Indians are doubly mad because anybody can make God. Half knowledge is a dangerous thing. The science of God is given in the Vedic literature. It is vast. Vast. Very systematic. But the sad part is nobody gives enough time to study the science. But here and there we hear. And when you hear half knowledge, then you make a mix-up and then you make a khichdi. And it will become a big joke actually. Around the world, nobody makes an ordinary man to be God. That happens only in India. Where the spiritual science has been given with so much detail, it's a big joke, it should happen in India. People know the spiritual science is great detail. So Lord Ramachandra is not that kind of a God. Not at all a mythology. The Purana means old history. Purana, in even ordinary Hindi, means old. Purana does not mean mythology. Correct? Okay? So Ramayana is one of the light of Purana. It's not among the 18 Puranas. It's a work of Valmiki. Vedavyasa wrote 18 Puranas. But this work was done way before in Treta Yuga. But even Vedavyasa has recorded it in Bhagavatam, recognizing it as an authorized history in the great thing is not waste his time. Telling bedtime stories. Many people have that foolishness. Many times tell them, why don't you read Krishna's life or Ramayana? They say, you have some story for my child. As if it is like some phantom target for children's reading. This is a discussion for the most intelligent brain. But today, intelligent brain are, instead of studying the Vedic literatures and entering into the science and mysteries of God, as given in the Vedic literature, are employed in IT, they are employed in so many places, and their energy is sapped. Morning 9 to 9, no time remaining even to study this. Actually, we should spend time. In Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Janma Karma Chame Divyam. The activities of the Lord are transcendent. And by understanding the activities, our life becomes sublime and successful. So first thing is, when Lord Ramachandra was born, he was quite young, say around 15 years old. Vishwamitra came and he said, can you send the students to Dasharatha? I have some big demons in the forest. I want them to deal with them. In fact, many of you know Ramayana. Dasharatha Maharaj was shocked, even at the proposal. All children are there to fight with Rakshasas. What is Vishwamitra trying? In fact, he cried a lot. Finally, Vishwamitra, you know, was adamant and he didn't want the curse of Vishwamitra. He said, okay. Vashishtha, his family priest said, don't worry. Vishwamitra says, means there is nothing to worry. He is a powerful sage. So he took the son and they killed powerful demons when they were just 15 years old. Very, very powerful demons. In fact, one of them was Maricha. Maricha was not killed but thrown thousands of miles away on the ocean. And then later, after coming back, on the way back, rather, Vishwamitra took them to Dasharatha. Sorry, to Janak Maharaj kingdom. And there, Janak Maharaj had a beautiful daughter by, we know the name of seen that. And he wanted to give this daughter to somebody who can break that bow. That was the challenge. It's like somebody in a hand. You solve this problem, can happen at all. That's like Swayambhu he created. So now when he came, because he was a king, and if he personally gives a daughter to somebody, then they have political, you know, problems. Why didn't give to me? So he said, okay, open Swayambhu. Then if you can, the bow was so big that some you can say 12-wheel or 18-wheel chariot was there to carry it. And 300 people were needed to lift it. Such a big bow it was. Most of the people came, looked at it and went away. Many people tried, could not even lift it 1 inch. Lord Rama came, lifted it, and then he strung it and broke it in the middle. In fact, it was such a big bow, when it broke, the sound made people faint. Such a thunderous sound came. This is inconceivable activity. How can somebody do that? Lift something which has been lifted by 300 people. Say 25 kilo average, 300 people, 7,500 kilo weight something to lift them. It's not easy. Just lift it and broke it. And then he was duly married, and then Dashrath also came, everybody came, big celebration happened. Everybody was happy. And not only Sita, her sisters are also married to the other brothers, cousins, sisters and sisters. They all came back to Ayodhya. And then for many years they were there in Ayodhya. And after some time, Dashrath Maharaj felt he is quite old, he should now retire. Not like today. Like you have the election going and a prime minister is 70 plus, difficult to walk also. Forget about lifting a bow. And then we have, you know, the other, what is that, Tamil Nadu, some other person, 80, 90 years, no problem. Previously, as soon as somebody is ready, young person, to take up the throne, immediately hand over. Not till the time of death they will hold. Like we had our first prime minister, when he was dying, he was crying, what will happen to my country if I die? Don't worry, there are many able people. You take care of yourself. People like this cannot leave a throne in Kaliyuga. So they used to leave for their, and they used to train the children as well. And the whole, all the sages, voting in the Vedic time was not from fools. Voting used to be done by respected people. Voting was there. It was a very unique combination of voting, democracy and monarchy. Very wonderful combination. So he called all the assembly of the sages, and they all came, they all said, yes, he is fit to rule this world. You have a wonderful son. We don't find anything equal in the kingdom. He's the best Kshatriya to rule. He was very happy to hear that. His appointment was confirmed. And he announced, tomorrow there was celebration started. Not like today, just like in Libya and so many places. The king is going, people are not sad. Some places people are very happy. Here, the whole kingdom was celebrating when he was to be enthroned. In whole Ayodhya there was celebration tomorrow. Today there is celebration when India wins a cricket match. That kind of celebration. But here the Supreme Lord is going to be our king. Whole kingdom was celebrating. There was a big celebration. It has a lot of benefit in this celebration. People are more wretched than today. The better things to celebrate. And when Lord Ramachandra came, he's also getting prepared. Suddenly, we all know KK, one of the wife of Lord Ramachandra, being, you know, she was Mantara, we say Mantara, one of her assistant, Mantara, she ate her head nicely. She cast a lot of aspersion in the decision of Dashrath. There was no aspersion like that. So she finally came and said to Dashrath that, no, your son is not, Ram is not going to be the king. My son, Bharat Maharaj is going to be the king.